All right, this is file number three for topic three. We talk about marketing. We normally heard the word sales and marketing. So do you know what is the difference between sales and marketing? Sales normally focus on the salesperson needs, whereby marketing focus on the consumer needs. What is the consumer needs? What are the consumer needs? Consumer needs and information. Okay. Consumer needs and information. So before they buy anything, they will look for information. Kan? Macam kamu lah kan? The same goes to you. If you want to buy anything, laptop ka, handphone ka, you will go for information. So where do you get the information from? It can be from the websites, kan? Kamu tanya. It can be from the sources that are like friends, tanya kawan, best ka, guna iPhone, kan? Kalau kawan cakap bagus, then you go to the website and then you search for the information. So who provide the information? It is from the marketing department. Marketing ni boleh dikira sebagai angel lah. Malaikat ni. Sebab apa? Sebab dia protect, bukan protect lah. Sebab dia give you as much as information before you decide. Before the consumer decide to buy. Whereby salesperson ni dia sedikit kejam. Why? Because salesperson ni normally given a target. Like for example, satu bulan ni you punya target is to sell 10 numbers of iPhone. Bos bilang sebulan kau punya target mau jual 10 biji iPhone. Kalau tidak dapat jual 10 biji, I will not give you any bonus. So that is salesperson. So salesperson ni akan cari orang lah. Kalau kamu buka WhatsApp tu, dia jadi macam kalau purple yang ada tanduk tu. Dia akan cuba meracun kamu. Belilah, belilah. This is the best in the market so far. So that is salesperson punya focus. Salesperson focus on the sales, on the needs, sales needs. Whereby marketing focus on the consumer needs. What are the needs of the consumer? Is to get information. Okay, so what is marketing? Marketing is the process of planning the hotel concept, types of facilities, service offered, and location. Marketing ni sebelum dia bagi information to customer consumer, dia sebenarnya cuba memahami what is the needs of the customer. Apakah keperluan customer? So itu under marketing. Orang marketing department akan conduct research to stay current with the needs and desire of the potential guest. Okay. So what is market segmentation? Okay. Market segmentation is a smaller identifiable group with common characteristic. Remember dalam kelas saya ada lukis satu pie kan? Satu bulatan. Contohlah pizza tu kan, dalam pizza tu ada slice of sausage. Ada pineapple slice, ada bacon, ada onions, kan? Ada cheddar cheese. Eh, bulan puasa kan, cakap pasal pizza pula. Okay. So, the round, the total round of a pizza is actually represent the total population of the markets. Satu bulatan pizza tu adalah mewakili populasi market. So mungkin onion ni ada 1% saja daripada total market, daripada total ingredient pizza tu kan. Pizza tu dia ada dia punya apa nama dia, crust. Crust tu of course lah 80% kan daripada pizza tu kan. So the same goes to market. Satu market, populasi market seluruh Malaysia ni, dia ada 100% lah, kita bagi dia percentage of 100%. out of 100% population, maybe 80% adalah middle income group. Middle income. Middle income mungkin okay, saya bagi middle income 40 lah, kita ikut standard kerajaan punya pecahan. Kamu tahu what is T20, what is M40, what is B40? Pernah dengar kan? Pernah nampak kan? T20 is top 20. M40 is middle 40 and B40 adalah below 40. Kalau 20 of 20% from the total market, dia punya income group maybe 1 million contoh. Okay. Maybe pendapatan dia adalah dalam Malaysia ni yang pendapatan 1 juta sebulan. Mungkin 20% dalam seluruh Malaysia ni ada 20%. Pendapatan dia adalah 1 juta. And then 40% pendapatan dia adalah 500,000. And then lagi 40% di bawah sekali ni adalah mungkin 100,000. Okay. So itu adalah pecahan market segmentation. Okay. Kenapa pentingnya kita bagi dia segment? Why is it so important for us to segmentize? To do a market segmentation, because we want to identify our target group. Can remember my example dalam kelas? If you are given a gun, you have a very limited bullets. Gun with a limited bullets. Maksudnya, kamu kena bagi senapang, pistol dengan beberapa peluru yang limited. Okay. The bullets represent represent the time, the energy, represent the efforts. Okay, so kalau kamu mau shoot, contohlah kan dart tu kan, kamu tahu dart tu yang orang main dart tu kan. Kalau kamu mau tengok dart tu, tengah-tengah tu yang paling kecil tu is merah kan. Merah tu very small kan. So bila kamu mau buat market, membuat aiming ataupun targeting, adakah kamu mau, kalau kamu ada very limited bullet, kan, of course you will go for big segment, kan, sebab the chance is very high, kan, untuk kena tu kan. Contohlah juga pie, carta pie tu kita bahagi dia dengan beberapa segmen besar, kecil. For example, 80%, ada 20%, ada 19%, ada 1%. Kamu ada limited bullet. Kamu mau pergi target di mana? Yang 1% tu ke ataupun yang 80%? Of course lah yang 80% kan, sebab kamu tak mau sia-siakan your, you don't want to waste your bullet. Kan? You have to be a very sharp shooter. Kena pergi shoot di segmen yang paling besar. So that is market segmentation. If you are able, macam mana mau buat dia? You have to put them into a small and identifiable group with common characteristic. So macam mana mau buat market segmentation ni? Contohnya, macam saya bagi dalam kelas kan, contoh kan. Okay, mau buat kereta. Bila mau buat kereta, kamu tanya market. Okay, market, how many of you like black color? Okay. Market mencakap, oh saya memang suka black ni. Okay, 50% of the total market say they want black color. And then 20% say they want pink color. And then yang hijau cakap 10%. Yang lain kata kuning. Okay. Okay, so berapa sudah tu? So yang paling besar is the black color, 50%. So as the producer, as a producer, do you think that you want to produce kereta warna pink? Sedangkan pink hanya 20%. Of course lah, tidak kan? Sebab nanti nobody would buy your car. Faham? So, bila kamu buat market segmentation itu important ke tidak? Yes, it is important. Why? Because you are trying to understand the market. Okay? Alright, faham? Okay. Now, kita pergi ni. Apakah kebaikan dan keburukan segmentation? Segmentation ni is very good because it give you a very clear understanding of the guest needs. Remember my example just now? At 50% prefer black color, 20% prefer pink color, only 1% prefer green color, the rest are yellow color, kan? So advantages there, you know your market very well sudah, kan? And then apa disadvantages there? Ada kalau dari segi konteks kita ni, of course it will satu it will needs it consume time lah to put them into their category kan, time and money consuming. Macam mana mau dapat tu, madam? Macam mana kita mau tahu dia semua hitam yang ni eh? Sebab they have to do research and research needs time. Sama macam banci penduduk Malaysia kan? Banci penduduk dibuat setiap 5 tahun sekali. Kenapa mesti buat banci penduduk, orang ketuk-ketuk rumah tu kenapa? Sebab they want to know kita ni belong to what group. Dalam Malaysia ni, contohnya macam segmentation eh, berapa persen yang income dia adalah 1 juta. Macam mana diorang tahu benda ni? Macam mana diorang tahu? Sebab diorang sudah buat bancian. Okay? And then apa lagi disadvantages dia? Kalau dari segi konteks kita, traveler ni, some of them, they don't want to be put into category. They don't want to be distinguished. They want to pukul rata saja. Market segmentation. They rasa macam apa nama dia? They want to get the same value for that, the same value of service. Contoh, kalau dia sudah buat market segmentation untuk 5-star hotel, they only want orang-orang yang high income group. What about the middle income group? Kan, middle income group mungkin akan rasa macam, apa nama? They want the same service too kan, so itu yang buat dia jadi keburukan lah kepada market segmentation ni, sebab market segmentation ni nanti dia akan very biased lah to the consumer. Okay, so what is marketing plan? There are two types of marketing plan, short terms and also long term. Short terms normally for a year or less lah, period. Kalau long term ni, they covers 5 years and above. The marketing plan, planning kita lah. Okay, pergi sini, baca sendiri yang tu. Okay, there are elements. Kalau dalam dari konteks kita ni, service industry, we are service industry, okay? Our four piece is typically different from four piece yang kamu learn in your economy subject. Kalau traditionally, there are only four piece introduced in your economic context. Price, place, apa lagi tu? Promotion and also product. Kan? Tapi in our context, since our product is different, service provide different products, different ni. Remember different characteristic of service product. Then kita ada, we are intangible, we are heterogeneity, we are not standard. Then remember in the class saya bagi kamu contoh kan, kenapa kita berbeza? Because we are not manufacturing. If manufacturing, they will produce the same product. Kalau a bottle of Rejoice tu, hijau botolnya hijau lah semua. Unlike our product. Hospitality product. Kita lain. So, we have 7 elements of marketing. Okay, apa elements dia adalah product. Product dari segi hotel industry, dia lain lah kan? Product. Product kita lain. Our product is to provide apa nama dia ni? Alamak, habis sudah kejap. Nanti saya sambung. Kejap, habis 15 minutes.